Tonight, from outer space, it's the Dell Talk Show. Today's stars, Galactic Ambassador David Liebe Hart, Space Tycoon CFO Bill, musical audio units from High Functioning Flesh, and of course me, Dirk the Martian, your spacey announcer. And now, the number one host orbiting the airwaves, Captain Alex Q. Mellor. Captain.
Hey, Dirk, you can stand down.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome. Welcome, everyone. I am, of course, Captain Alex Q. Mellor. Welcome to the Dell Talk Show. How are you doing today, Dirk?
Wonderful.
Yeah, it's hard to tell when it's daytime and nighttime here in outer space.
Feeling a little frisky right now.
Okay, well, that's cool, too. Well, so much has been going on in the universe. We all know this story, the big story. The mayor of Rigel 6 has been forced to resign after admitting to having used cocaine. Talk about blasting off. Oh, my God. And, of course, we know this. They've discovered a new black hole that's said to suck matter in at a greater rate than any discovered before. Upon hearing of the hole's magnificent suction power, the galactic president immediately went to investigate. Classic Bill Dar Clintron, am I right?
Yes, I am.
And, Dirk, a big congratulations to you. It's been 7 years. The time flies up here. But it's time for mating season on your home planet.
Yes, it is.
In the Martian home planet. You excited?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, did you tell?
I mean,
I'm not just glad to see you.
I mean, I know what you're like normally. I hate to see what you're going to be like in heat.
Yeah. Right.
But no, seriously, we're on our way there now. Isn't that right?
Oh, thank goodness. Yes, we are.
How did the last one go?
It was good. You know, a lot of babes, a lot of fun, a lot of this, that, and of course the other thing. You know, and
And finally, we know that the latest craze sweeping the galaxy is breathing in these exotic space spores that make you blissfully happy, seemingly with no consequences. Everybody heard about this? Yeah, well, always wanting to keep up with the latest trends, we've decided to test it out right here on the show. This is Space Spores. Let's get Ben out here, please. Hey, Ben, how you doing? So, just open it up like this here, and you sniff them in, I guess.
Large. Oh, well.
Well, that's not what we intended to happen. We'll be right back. Thanks for coming back. My first guest has been praised throughout the universe for negotiating peace between the Carinians and the Omegans. Please welcome Ambassador David Liebe Hart. Hey, David.
What's that?
Great to see you here in outer space.
Well, good to be here.
You spend a lot of time in outer space, though.
I sure do. Of trying to get the Omegans and Corinthians to finally get along. They've had a 200-year war.
Well, you've been making a lot of progress, I heard, though.
I know. Meldraman visits me,
sure.
So does Jezadel. Jezadel's last name is Ordeus, from where the country she comes from.
Okay. When you go with your friends in space, do you ever go to the Five Moon Festival?
Sometimes. I'm teaching them punk rock music. I'm teaching how to jazz up the music. It's better than that old grandpa classical music.
Now, what about at the Seven Moon Festival?
Well, the Seven Moon Festival, they really party with those young alien girls. The Omegan girls are like the Irish girls here. They are hot.
Dirk is he's going to mate. We're going to it's mating season for the Martians.
Yeah, I'll tell you. Well, since he's, I heard he had an Hispanic wife, so he could mate with an Omegan or a Carinian woman.
That was it.
They have vaginas and penises like we do.
Wow.
The Omegan women have tits and China vaginas like regular female Earth women have here.
I did want to talk a little bit about what is this. We use a lot of physics here in space, you know, to make the ship go and stuff, but what are metaphysics?
Metaphysics teach you positive thinking. In fact, the New Age religion uses rocks for positive vibrations, and the Omegans and Corindians use crystals to travel in their spaceships for positive vibrations, and many of them control the spaceships through mind over matter.
Oh my God, David, what is that on your lap?
That's an EB. They are like bed bugs. They're all over my apartment. I don't want to rent to them.
Oh God. Seems.
They seem to be multiplying.
It seems harmless enough. God.
You shouldn't have done that. They're gonna be mad.
Big deal. As long as they don't get in the control room, we'll be fine. How are things going in there, Adam? Well, anyway, David, I think we have a clip from your new movie. Let's roll that. Okay, Adam? Adam? Oh boy, not again. We're gonna set the computer to direct the rest of the show, and we'll be right back, so sit tight.
Can I just take a bathroom?
Yes. Hello?
Hey, man. You got a minute?
Sure, what's up?
Well, I'm going to space soon, and, you know, if I don't make it back, I just wanted to say I really appreciate you as a friend.
Hey, thanks, man. You're not so bad yourself.
Space travel is still risky. Before your next mission, let them know you care. A message from the Galactic Ad Council.
All right. My next guest is a self-made space billionaire who's also a strong proponent of asteroid mining. I'm not sure how I feel about all this alternative energy stuff, but let's see what he has to say. Here's CFO Bill. Careful with the leavings.
Hey, Bill, good to see you.
CFO Bill.
Very nice to see you, Mr. Miller.
Yeah, we've actually never met in person, but I'm a fan of your column in Forbes.
Thanks. You know, it's just an opportunity to get the correct ideas out into the world.
Yeah, because you're a businessman.
Correct, yes.
A CFO, son of an immigrant factory worker.
True.
But you sold your first technology companies for billions, and you invested in asteroid mining.
Yes, and if you don't know what asteroid mining is...
We don't.
Yes, it's a way of getting natural gas.
Is it like a propulsion system?
Like the what?
Anti-gravity compulsion system.
Well, that's more that's science fiction. This is more of the reality of a way of getting natural gas, which is basically we're mining asteroids using high pressurized water, blasting the insides out to find these spaces where we can obtain the natural gas.
That seems like a waste of water to me.
But the thing is, it's a cheaper fuel through all of the ways of obtaining it than petroleum. So
see, our show runs on petroleum.
Yeah.
I think it's a fine fuel. I don't know how you would build the infrastructure for a natural gas space fleet.
Well, that's the thing is anytime building is in the equation, all it's going to do is create more jobs.
But it pollutes the environment. It pollutes outer space.
Yep.
We only have one galaxy. And
didn't you learn about the 21st century fracking debacle?
Yeah, which actually, in hindsight, we found out was correct.
I don't know. I'm just kind of worried that none of this is renewable. None of this asteroid mining is renewable.
On the inside, we know that it's not renewable, but that's fine because it's a bridge fuel. All right, we had petroleum, and now we're going to be using the natural gas as a bridge fuel until we get into interstellar, interdimensional fuels. We're not there yet. You mentioned the anti-gravity as a source. We're not there. We're not there yet.
We're not. Bad.
That's what I'm saying.
I like fossil fuel. I'm still not totally convinced, but...
Well, I think seeing it work will show you.
Okay, so that's the... You got a knob or something?
See, perfectly safe.
What the hell? Oh my God.
Now look what you've done. No one kills a member of my crew and gets away with it.
That's right.
We'll be right back with CFO Bill's court-martial and high-functioning flesh.
With its modern temperatures and Earth-like atmosphere, Talos 4 is the ideal uncharted planet. This year, send a landing party to Talos 4. Talos 4, go beyond.
This is crazy! How am I supposed to get a fair trial?
Silence! Your money won't buy your way out of this one. It'll make me sick. My musical guest tonight is a...
Man, quiet. This is Dwayne from the planet Altadena. Alex Q. Mella, for your unjust persecution of this peaceful but less handsome cracker, you shall be punished. Prepare for judgment on our home planet.
Oh my God. They disabled the transporter with some kind of force field.
Hey, there may be a way to save him. If I can reroute power from the show's engines, we might be able to create an energy source so big that it could temporarily disrupt the force field.
Like bowling balls knocked falling from the pins.
Precisely. Oh. However, to create a surge that big, we'll need all the Petronium on board, which means we won't have enough to make it to the Martian mating ceremony, Dirk. You're gonna have to choose between your friends your urges.
Oh, why do we have to be so dependent on that darn fossil fuel?
No sex, be a virgin.
Ladies and gentlemen, high functioning flesh.
He's badly hurt. I don't think science can save him.
We don't need science. I can cure him with metaphysics.
My gosh, she seems to be coming around.
Ooh.
Hocus pocus is really good stuff.
He must have used metaphysics.
Yeah.
Positive. Mind over matter.
Positive
Christian
thinking.
Science of mind.
Hey, buddy. What's up? Skipper? What's up?
I'd like to thank all my guests tonight, especially you, CFO Bill. Clearly, I've misjudged you. However, there's still the matter of your court-martial.
Isn't there another way? Dirk never did get to mate.
Yeah.
Hey, that's true.
What's up with that?
What do you say, Dirk?
I think I got an idea.
Yeah.